I'm here alongside Dr. Rashmiranjan, who is the intervention radiologist at GKNM. Let's hear it from him on what intervention radiology is all about.
If you'll see intervention radiology, it is the branch of radiology which uses different techniques and different catheters, wires to treat different diseases of the body. Here we don't open the, we don't cut, we don't use a blade. Everything is done by a small hole and by using a small needle. So the history of intervention radiology is like that. It started all in 1950 and 60. When Charles Dutter, he's a radiologist in US, he opened up a blocked vessel in an elderly lady who was suffering from gangrene of her toes. After opening the vessel, the toe got amputated, auto-amputated, so she got relief of her disease and pain. So this is how intervention radiology started. After that, till date, we are doing a lot of treatment by using this minimal invasive techniques, starting from head, from stroke up to the leg. So this is all about intervention radiology.
So what are the common causes for vascular diseases, and which are the most common cases you have found so far?
Vascular diseases are the most common cause of death. If you will see worldwide, the most common cause of death is ischemic heart disease, followed by stroke. So overall, the vessels of our body are the main culprits. The diseases of the vessels of the body are the main culprit to cause death. So if the vessels of our heart gets affected, then it causes heart attack. We call it ischemic heart disease. If the vessels of our brain got affected, we call it stroke. Similarly, the vessels of our legs can get affected. We call it peripheral vascular disease. So all this disease process belongs to one pathogenesis. We call it atherosclerotic vascular disease. And it happens, it is a natural process. It's a natural process. It starts after birth. Maybe in the first decade it starts, then gradually it progresses. But what happens if a patient suffers from diabetes, hypertension, dyslipidemia, or is a smoker? Then this atherosclerotic process got accelerated. Once it gets accelerated, it causes occlusion of the vessels. So once there is occlusion of the vessels, so the blood supply will be less to that vessel. Suppose the occlusion happens in the heart, then what will happen? Then the blood supply to the heart muscles will come down. It will cause ischemia, it will cause pain, and sometimes it may cause sudden death also. Suppose blood supply to brain gets affected, then it will cause stroke. So patient will not be able to move one side of his body, will not able to speak, will not able to see. All these are the symptoms of stroke. And if the blood vessel to the legs gets affected, then it causes pain in the leg. It may be acute, sudden, or it may be chronic. It may occur over a period of time. If it is acute, then what will happen? Patient will come with severe pain in the leg. We call it acute limb ischemia. And in acute limb ischemia, if you remove the clot from the legs, then the patient will get benefit. Patient will get relief of pain. If we are not doing that, sometimes patient may have to lose the limb. So as an intervention radiologist, we treat all those aspects of block in the blood vessels. And another thing is, if there is a block in the venous system, so there are two systems of our body. One is arterial system, which supplies the blood to the organs, and another is venous system, which takes the blood from the organ to the heart. And if there is a disease in the venous system also, there is a block in the venous system, that also as an intervention radiology we treat it. Suppose there is block in the veins of the leg and abdomen, that will cause severe pain in the leg and swelling. And sometimes that clot may go into the lungs. We call it pulmonary embolism. If pulmonary embolism happens, sometimes it may be massive. Sometimes it may lead to the death of the patient, and sometimes it is mild. So if it is mild, then we treat it conservatively by giving injections and medicines. But if it is massive, then we go ahead and we do some treatment to dissolve that clot and remove that clot. That is called thrombectomy or embolectomy. So these are all the aspects of different diseases we treat as intervention radiologists.
When should people come if they have cardiovascular disease, or I would say what would be the right time for them to come, and what are the treatments you offer for cardiovascular diseases?
Regarding vascular disease, I would like to say prevention is better, because it's a ongoing process. As you know, in India, a lot of diabetic patients are there. India is the capital of diabetes. So this is the complication of diabetes, like call it peripheral vascular disease. In peripheral vascular disease, what happens? There will be accelerated atherosclerosis, there will be block in the blood vessels of the leg. So the patient will come with symptoms of leg pain. First, to start with, they will tell, while walking we are having pain in the leg. Then the pain will subside once they take rest. Again they will start walking, again they will have pain. So this is the typical symptom, we call it intermittent claudication or claudication pain. If the patient is having this type of symptoms, they should consult their doctors. And first we see the patient, we examine, we see the pulses, peripheral pulses, whether they are present or absent. Then we do a test, simple test, we call it Doppler test. In Doppler test we found out where is the block. If there is a block, then the next step is we ask them to take some medicines as well as to change their lifestyle. Lifestyle modification is the most important thing in the initial stages of vascular disease of our body. In peripheral vascular disease, the most important thing, if the patient is smoking, he should stop smoking. If he is a diabetic, hypertensive, he should take his medications properly so that the progression of disease will not be that much if they will take properly the medicines they will take properly. Then we advocate them to walk. Even if there is pain, we ask the patient to walk, because by walking it increases the blood circulation to your leg and it increases the collateral formation. So the graded walking exercise is one of the treatment modality in intermittent claudication. Then we give some blood thinners and we adjust the doses of lipid lowering agents. And in spite of all this, if the patient comes to us with rest pain, severe pain at rest, sometimes the patient will not be able to lie down, patient will not be able to sleep at night, and sometimes they will come with healing, a non-healing ulcer of the toes, legs, foot. At that time, that is the time we intervene. We admit the patient, we evaluate, then we try to open the vessel. Suppose there is a block in the aorta or iliac arteries or femoral arteries, different, the block can be at different levels. Depending on the level of occlusion, we open it up. And for opening, there are two techniques. One is endovascular technique, one is surgical technique. If it is suitable for endovascular technique, we open it up by using a needle, some catheters and balloons and stents. But if it is not suitable for endovascular techniques, then we refer the patient to our colleagues, to our vascular surgeon or cardiothoracic colleagues, where they do a bypass. Do a bypass to supply, to increase the blood flow to the legs. This is how we manage the peripheral vascular disease patients.
On an average, how many cases do you see at GKNM? And what are the stats at the India level?
This peripheral vascular disease is quite common. It's not a rare entity. As the population becomes more aging and more and more number of diabetic people are living a longer life, this disease is becoming more and more common. In an average per annum, I am seeing in my OPD around 800 to 900 patients of peripheral vascular disease. If you will see all over India statistics, it will be around 10 million per year. So this is the statistics of peripheral vascular disease.